गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन एंड वेलकम टू योर इंग्लिश क्लास. चिल्ड्रन, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी वन चैप्टर फ्रॉम योर इंग्लिश बुक प्रोज. एंड द चैप्टर विच वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी टुडे, दैट चैप्टर इज द लास्ट लेसन. वॉट इज गिवन इन दिस चैप्टर? फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई विल टेल यू इन ब्रीफ. दिस चैप्टर इज ऑल अबाउट द इम्पॉर्टेंस ऑफ मदर टंग. इन दिस चैप्टर you will see that how the main character, who was a young boy and he was studying in a school, throughout his academic life he never gave any importance to what his teachers were telling him, and suddenly one day he came to know that his mother tongue, which was used by him and rest of his friends in the school, by teachers of his school, that mother tongue ceased to be spoken. So now I am coming directly to the story. Actually, the main character of this story is a young boy whose name is Franz. Franz was a school student like other students, and one day he was given homework by his teacher, Mr. Hamel had told Franz to prepare participle. So next morning, when he was supposed to go to school, he was reluctant. He was not willing to go to school. The reason was that the topic which was given by the teacher, Mr. Hamel, this boy Franz had not prepared that topic. And the other reason was that the morning was a very fine morning. So because of these two things, this boy Franz was reluctant to go to school. But anyhow, he won over this temptation and finally he decided to go to school. So while he was going to school, he saw many changes that day. When he passed through the place where there used to be a bulletin board, he saw that some people were gathered there. There was a crowd. So this boy, he could not understand that why so many people are standing near the bulletin board. And he hurried off for the school because he was getting late. And when he reached the school, there also he noticed some changes. What changes he noticed? That the school normally, which was full of shouting and growling of the children that day, strangely it was silent. And he felt that it was not a school day, but it was Sunday. But in reality it was not Sunday, it was a school day. So when he entered the school and reached the class, there also, to his surprise, the atmosphere was very different from other days. All the children were sitting silently, and some old people of the village were also present in the class, and they were also sitting at the back of the class on the benches. And his teacher, Mr. Hamel, he too was looking different. And why he was looking different? Because that day, Mr. Hamel, his teacher, was wearing one of his fine clothes, fine dress, which he normally used to wear on some special occasions and on some special days only. But that day he was wearing his special dress. This boy took permission to sit in the class, and that was also a surprise for this boy, because Mr. Hamel was very polite. He did not say anything, and this boy sat in the class. And when Mr. Hamel, he started speaking and told the children and the grown-ups who were sitting in the class that today was the last day of the French lesson, then this news, especially for this boy, was like a shock. Why? Because the French language, which was the mother tongue, which Mr. Franz was teaching to the students for such a long time, that French language was ceased to be spoken. There was order from the Berlin, and that order was that French language will not be taught in schools and people will not be speaking French language anymore, and only German language will be taught. So it was a shock for this boy, because now onwards he will not be able to study his mother tongue. He will not be allowed to speak French language with his friends and his teachers. So it was a shock for this boy. And the same moment this boy started repenting that why for such a long period he ignored his own language, his own mother tongue. And ultimately, Mr. Franz, he told the student that today or that day was the last day of him working in that school. When this boy was sitting in the class, the same time he could listen upstairs the sound of footsteps. Someone was walking upstairs. Actually, Mr. Hemmel was living there with his sister, and his sister was moving upstairs packing all the belongings, because the next day they were supposed to leave that school, to leave that place. And when Mr. Hemmel completed the class, he wrote something very important on the blackboard. And what he wrote, the meaning of that line was, "Vive la France." Actually, he wrote it in French. The meaning of this line in English is, "Live long France." And he told the students that day the importance of mother tongue. And he told the students that until you have command on your mother tongue, the freedom of the country is not far from you. Any moment you can get the freedom. But if you forget your mother tongue, then you remain slave for your whole life. Not only you, your coming generations also, they remain slave. So it is very important that we should stick to our mother tongue, and we should give the due respect to our mother tongue.